How did that journey and sort of unfold from there? What were the efforts that you took to get to the first step of being the influencer, the advocate that everyone knows of now?
Actually, I remember when I was a school student, we had all the time police officers coming to do campaigns on road safety, teaching us how to cross the road safely. They did a lot of writing competitions and drawing competitions just to know how we perceive safety on the streets. And like in Jordan, it's something very common that we hear about every single day, the death of young people because of road crashes. And people just like accept it. Even though it happens so frequently, it's on the news on a daily basis. But people think, okay, it's destiny. It's their fate to die because of a road crash. And to me, this is not fair. Like, this can be me. It can be someone I love. It can be one of my friends, you know, anyone of my family. And in Jordan, we're a small country. So I always say Jordanian people are my bigger family. So the loss of any Jordanian is feels like a personal loss to me. If I see a mom weeping on TV because she lost her child because of a road crash, I can feel her pain. And I wish that we can do something to hold people accountable because of the tragedy that happened. No one should die because of a road crash. Because I believed in this cause so much, I found that by studying it and by, you know, having professional experience in it, then I can contribute to my country and help save lives. Because I did a quick search and I found that we're one of the highest countries of fatalities caused by road crashes. And we don't have many people experienced in this field. We don't have an agency, a lead agency, working to lower the number of fatalities and serious injuries caused by road crashes. So I felt like this is a step that I need to take. There are so many architects in Jordan, but not so many road safety experts. And that's when I decided, you know, to move to Beirut to study sustainable mobility and road safety management. And this specialty wasn't available in any university in Jordan. There, I met people from different countries in the Arab world. And then later, I could move to Geneva to do my internship with the Global Road Safety Partnership. And I learned a lot about how do we shape policies that save lives. And I had my main focus on saving the lives of youth, because every year we lose around 300,000 people on the world's numbers. It's a huge number. Like, it's almost like 1,000 young lives lost every single day on the streets globally. So we are one of the most affected age group by this epidemic. And I felt like we need to do something about it. Whenever I hear organizations, you know, talking about working with youth, they mention the climate, how young people, you know, are the most affected by climate change, for example. They talk about gender equality, how do we as youth identify our gender today? And we talk about animals' rights, you know, we talk about how we should change our diet, how we should change our mobility trends. But no one is talking about the number one killer of youth. When I ask this question to anyone, they think maybe it's, I don't know, depression, or is it suicide? But in reality, no, it's a road crash. So by simply leaving your house every day to go to your university or to go to your work, or to simply, I don't know, buy something from the supermarket, you need to cross the street, right? So there's a huge chance that you might lose your life because of that. And I found that we need more young people working in this field, because as the most affected age group, we should decide how should our cities, you know, be designed to protect us as youth. And we should have a place at the decision-making tables to have a say about the policies that need to protect us. And we should hold all the decision makers accountable, not as victims, but as peers. Like, we should be seated with decision makers and share the decision making process. Because, you know, young people are usually underestimated. And this is something that bugs me a lot. We have a huge potential and we should be addressed and taken seriously. And there is so much that we can offer to the world.